long time ago, my wife asked me, we're sitting having dinner, she said, hey, you know what, would you go back to UK? I said, oh, in a heartbeat. And when I came back from the Olympic trials, I said, remember that heartbeat thing you talked about a long time ago? Yeah. Well, it's going to happen. And when we saw her chuckle, she kind of knew right away. She said, I've already found a house. So. The whole family was on board. We're doing this. My son, basketball player, my daughter, 5, 10, and 14 years old, so I think they've all grown up in athletics. And my wife reminds me constantly, more often than I need to hear, that she has a medal and I don't. No matter how good of a coach I am, she has hardware and I don't. And so I have to bow down to that, knowing that she has a Olympic silver medal and I don't. And my son tells me that I'm short, and he's 6'5", and I'm not good there either. And my daughter keeps measuring herself against me, thinking that one day she also will be taller than me. So you kind of see the house that I live in, and that's sort of the mentality that I have as a person. If you're going to do something, you need to do it to the best of your ability of money at all. I'm not interested in coming here and sort of easing out of this thing. A friend of mine said that sucking is not something I want to ease out of. I'm not interested in easing out of where we are here today. We're going to have to bust ourselves out of it. That's my interest. I want to win. I want to be competitive. I want to mentor young people enough to make an impact that hopefully when they grow older, they got kids, and hopefully their middle name can be Edrick. Yeah, that'd be a good thing. I've actually been with a lot of my former athletes are now married and have children. I actually went to see them and talk to them, so they kind of get a little bit older. Team doctor at Stanford is the guy that I coach, so I'm getting old. I recognize that, but I think there's an impact that we can make on the people that is lasting, that is important, not just to coach them, not just to teach them how to jump over stuff and run fast, but just to make an impact that helps them become young people that we can depend on as a community, as a university. I think it's important to make that impact in all their lives and to make a change. Not everybody's want to bend what's important in our society values, but we're going to have to teach it. And I think that it's our goal to lose as few of them as we can. Not everybody's going to want to do that, but it is it's my goal and my responsibility to make sure that we reach all of them if possible. And that's my goal to also make sure that we get some hardware. I'm not interested in participating. I don't think I have a chance to win. That's not a game I want to play. But I'm not sure that we really have a chance to win. I think we're going to find a way to do it. Can't say when, but I can tell you that it's going to be as soon as possible. We're going to have to go through our butts off. We're going to have to kind of get this thing done. This job has a way out. I think this job, but I think it's an opportunity to recruit from 5% of the population at Stanford to 95% of the population here at UK. So that's a lot more people. I'm definitely in love with the idea of people who recruit more student athletes and be in a community that appreciate what I do. And I think that's the difference. I was here way back when, so I know how it used to be. And I can promise you that Mitch played a huge role in it. I would not be here without the conversation we had at the Olympic trials. And I was pretty much shocked to hear things that I've never heard about in the UK when I was here. But I've never heard the words winning, doing it right, and mentoring it. It's a different community, it's a different environment. Buy a used car for my son, and the guy knew my name and knew that I'd been hired. And I told my son, you know, you need to pay attention because you can't get stuck here. I don't know. Everybody will know who you are. And that's the community I want to be part of, a community that really cares about the members here that appreciate athletics. Not just winning trophies, but just what we do for young people, the kind of young people we put out there. And that's really why I'm here. Is an opportunity that's unlike any other. And I think I'm leading here. And I think what I have to offer will be valued and will be important. I can say that when I left UK, I was not prepared to be a head coach. I think the things that I've learned, I spent with the person that I've become. think they're anticipating a little bit more pain than they used to, but I think they're excited to know that, that this is something that's important to me. Whatever they're going to go through, I'm going to go through it with them. That's my philosophy. We're going to be a family. We're going to spend time together as a team. And as coaches, we've got to invest more than just 20 hours a week in training. We've got to invest in knowing who they hang out with, where they go to their majors, their favorite movies, and all that stuff. That's important for them to know that we give a hoot about what they do as people. And that's the philosophy of my staff. They all want to be involved. Their cell phone is paid by UK, so if the kid calls, they better pick up their cell phone. And that's important that they didn't know that the staff is available to talk to them and help them to whatever issue they're going with, whatever they have time that is. And that's a kind of community service that we do for our team. So if you guys have any questions, shoot away, but that's my spiel. And I fit the mission from the hip, so what you hear is what you get. So maybe I need to filter it a little bit more. But just a regular old guy trying to go out there and win some championship and get good people and have a good student at the University to the highest level.
Edrick, can you walk us through?